Welcome to the hard@engineer.com. I am Varun Patel. In this video, you will learn about how to read P&ID. Piping and instrumentation diagram is also known as process engineering flow scheme, which is PEFS. You will learn how to read P&ID and PEFS with the help of actual plant drawing. P&ID is more complex than PFD and includes lots of detail. Because of this, you have to watch the video till the end to understand all the aspects of this drawing. Please subscribe to my channel. It helps me to increase my reach on YouTube and you will also get regular updates on new video. You can subscribe right now by just clicking the subscribe button on the right hand side of the screen. What is P&ID? P&ID is a graphical representation of the actual process plant using various symbols that represent actual equipment. As said earlier, it is a complicated than PFD. A single PFD can have a multiple P&ID. This means if some system is shown on a single PFD, to show the same system on P&ID, it may require multiple P&ID sheets. It is one of the main deliverables of FEED, that is front-end engineering and design. It is used during the entire life cycle of the plant. That means during EPC, pre-EPC and operation. Use of P&ID during pre-EPC phase. P&ID is used to derive project capital cost estimate. It is also used to develop the EPC contract specification. Plot plan is developed considering various inputs from the P&ID and physical site locations. Use of P&ID during EPC phase. During design, P&ID defines the design basis for the piping and instrumentation disciplines. During the EPC phase, P&ID is used to develop the individual unit layout. It is used to identify the hazardous area classification, preparing data sheets for equipment, walls, and instruments. P&ID are used to develop the piping layout and preparing bulk material takeoff for the piping, electrical, instrumentation, and civil. It is a vital document for various reviews such as HACCP, SIL and operability review. During operation, you have to maintain P&ID in a such a condition that it will show actual plant condition at any time. It should be updated when any physical change is made so that the unit will remain compliant with code, standard and specification, and can be operated safely under the defined process conditions. P&ID are used to train operators and engineers before they start work in plant. It is also used for work permit planning. What information does P&ID provide? All the equipment, including install spare, the associated piping, including drain and vent lines. P&ID will give you the service description of each equipment along with the relevant design condition. Next is heat tracing, insulation, jacket stitching, personal protection requirement for the pipeline and equipment. It also provides instrumentation along with control loop detail. It shows local and panel instruments along with associated logic such as start or stop. Information about the process and utility pipelines. P&ID will show size, service, material, line number and piping class for the pipeline. Tagged piping components such as control wall, safety wall and all other walls along with their size, class and tag number are also shown on P&ID. Change in battery limit between contractor and vendor, change in pipe class and change in discipline ownership. Information required for design, construction and operation such as the slope of the line, minimum and maximum distance from the equipment or instruments, minimum straight length after the instrument, elevation of the equipment, safe location discharge requirement. These are the information that covers in P&ID. What is not included in P&ID? Process condition and physical data, operating condition, stream flow details, equipment locations, pipe routing, length and fittings, supports and structural detail are not included in P&ID. okay, now you know what P&ID is and type of information you are going to get from the drawing. Let's confirm this with the help of actual P&ID. Before you move further, please like and share this video because it helps in YouTube ranking. This is a PFD of ATF system, shown the entire system of ATF supply to the Myrox unit. The function of Myrox unit is to remove sour gases from the ATF. This process is also known as a sweetening process. This is a simplest system with just one control tank and two centrifugal pump. Here, ATF is coming from the CDU. You can see here that ATF is coming from ATF rundown line to the tank, and with the help of the pump, it is supplied to Myrox unit. Hope the function of the system is clear to you. Now let's move to P&ID. There are two P&IDs for the OSBL part of this system and many more for ISBL parts. I will explain you OSBL part of the system. I have a full course on how to read P&ID with lots of other types of P&ID, such as pump, vessel, exchanger, column and many more. If you want to become an expert, you can check my course, link is given in the description. Reading P&ID is nothing but the reading of symbols. So if you have not seen the earlier video on the P&ID symbol and how to read PFD, this will be the difficult for you to understand this drawing. Links of this video are given in the description. So if you have not seen this video, please watch this video for the better understanding. If possible, get printout of P&ID in A3 and follow the video. You can download this P&ID by visiting my website, the link is given in the description. It is always good practice to start reading P&ID from the main incoming line and follow the fluid path. Here ATF is coming from CDU, you can see the line number. The diameter of incoming line is 6 inch NPS, which is equivalent to 150 mm DN. The different company follows different terminology for the line number, but it contains same information such as line size, unit number, commodity code that identify fluid inside the line, circuit number, line sequence number, piping class that gives all detail about piping components and their material, insulation and coating requirements. Here N means there is no insulation. If there is a H, then is a hot insulation. C is for cold insulation, A is for acoustic reduction, P is for personal protection, F is for fireproofing. It also gives information about whether the line is steam trace or electric trace. Normally, ET is used for electrical tracing and ST is used for steam tracing. Let's move ahead. Here you can see that ATF is divided into two streams. We follow this stream. 6 inch line is getting reduced to 4 inch. Don't get confused with reducer symbol. It is just indication of the line size change. In the piping, it may be reducing T as it is 6 inch to 4 inch concentric reduction. Now, this triangle with the line indicates a line break. A line break is the demarcation of the line number change. So, whenever you see this symbol, it is used to indicate that from that point onward, line number is different. This is 4 inch line number. This is a bypass loop for the flow transmitter. You can see that Venturi type flow meter provided in between the two gate valve. Why did I say it is Venturi type flow meter? Latest VM indicates the type of flow meter. It gives flow indication on the control panel. You can see the connection shown between FT and FI. From the piping point of view, you can see that there is a 1 inch drain wall is given in between the two gate valve. The letter D indicates that it is a drain wall, and if it is a V, then it is a vent wall. Note that if it is a vent, it will be shown on the top side and not on the bottom. The bypass valve is also a gate valve which will remain closed during normal operation. You can see the letter NC which indicates the same. Reading P&ID is nothing but reading P&ID symbols. So if you are aware of the symbol, you can easily understand the P&ID. If you want to become an expert in reading P&ID, you can buy my course How to Read P&ID Like an Expert that has many different types of P&ID example that makes you confident to read any type of P&ID that you will come across. Link is given in the description. Here you can see the motor operated butterfly valve. Lots of instruments are shown here, but it is not that complicated. If you are aware of MOV, you know that it can be operated locally or from the control panel. You can read at valve level, that means this instrument function is available on the valve itself. HS indicate hand switch. With these switches, you can put MOV on manual control or remote control, that means on panel control. You can also start or stop the valve from the field. HSO means open and HSC means close. The data link indicates this valve is connected to the control panel. The last two instrument bubble show the position and status of the valve. From field, you can set and see the percentage of the valve opening, and you can also check that the valve is open or closed. Next is a drain valve that is located at the lowest point. This is the spectacle blind with normally closed configuration. If the dark ring is toward the valve, as in this case, it indicates that solid ring covers and isolates the joint during the normal operation. If the only circle is toward the valve, as shown here, that means the hollow ring is inside and line is live during normal operation. Below the drain valve, the funnel is shown. So when you drain ATF, it will go to COC system. COC means continuous amyl contaminated that used to drain hydrocarbon. The second type of drain is AOC, that means accidentally oil contaminated system. After dyke valve, there is a pneumatically controlled globe valve is there. You can see the pneumatic line symbol. Like MOV, the pneumatic valve also has a various switches to operate the valve locally and from the control panel. You can also see the three-way valve connected to the pneumatic line to operate the actuator. You can refer to the abbreviation table to understand the meaning of all this instrument bubble. I have attached this table with the free download. The link is given in the description. You can see that there is a relief valve in the bypass. It used to protect the actuator from the surge. Next is a tank. First, I will explain you mechanical parts and then instrumentation. As you can see, this is the fixed roof tank. On the top of the P&ID, you can see the detail of each of the equipment shown in the drawing. Let's see the detail of the tank. The tank is 20 meter in height with 9 meter diameter. You can also see the operating pressure and temperature of the tank. The material of the construction is a carbon steel and there is no insulation. Now let's go back to the tank. N1 to N17 are nozzle number. P&ID shows the tentative location of the nozzle and also shows the size of the nozzle. Manholes are shown as M1 to M3. The broken line shows internal piping. There is a vortex breaker with N7 nozzle connected to the pump suction line with normally closed gate valve. This is because the main suction line is N2. N7 will only use when you want to drain the tank completely. There are two more nozzles, N5 and N6, that used to drain the tank to COC. This is open type liquid seal that prevent air ingress into the tank. Now let's check the instrumentation. For safe operation of any equipment, you have to monitor pressure, temperature and level. Here you can see the pressure transmitter near the tank bottom plate. On the top of the roof, you can see the radar type level indicator and transmitter. The temperature gauge is shown as a TE, that is a temperature element. This arrangement shows the multiple thermocouple installed at the different height of the tank. This will ensure that you will get an average temperature of the tank as the liquid has a different temperature at different level. LZT is a level safety transmitter. Here you can see the value of LLL, HLL and HHLL. LLL means low liquid level, HLL means high liquid level and HHLL means high liquid level. LLL protects your prompt, and when tank level reach to LLL, it give the alarm in control panel, and based on the logic configuration, it may trigger to switch off command to the pump. HLL and HHLL will use to protect the tank from overfilling. When liquid level reach to the HLL, it gives the alarm, and when reach to HHLL, it will trigger the safety logic and stop the fluid supply to the tank. There is a breather valve on the tank. It will protect the tank from the overpressure and vacuum. Now, this all instrument bubble are sending the information to the control panel for the pressure, level and temperature instrument that I have explained to you. You may have noticed that there is a tank gauging system which receives all input signal from this instrument. Tank gauging system is used to calculate the quantity of the liquid stored in the tank at any given time. Based on the diameter, level and temperature, it will calculate the quantity of the liquid stored in the tank. QI is a quantity indicator. In the last part of this video, let's check what going out of the tank. ATF from the tank is supplied to the pump with the help of 6-inch pipeline. You can see that inside the dike there is a manual gate valve with the bypass arrangement. This is safety relief valve on the bypass. Outside the dike, you can see the motor operated butterfly valve. This MOV has a similar switches as I explained you earlier to operate the valve locally and from the control panel. If you know the instrument legend and symbols, you can read and understand any P&ID. As said earlier, if you want to become an expert in reading down P&ID, you can buy my course How to Read P&ID Like an Expert that has many different type of P&ID example that makes you confident to read any type of P&ID that you will come across. Link is given in the description. You can download this P&ID with instrument code table by visiting my website hardhatengineer.com. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates on new video. Please like and share my video with your friends. If you want to request a video, write in the comment. See you soon. Goodbye. Take care.